Hi everyone. This is Dr. S. Chandramakrishan, working as a professor in the Department of ECE. Yeah, today topic is applications of operational amplifiers. Already we have seen there is different amplifiers or the instrumentation amplifiers. There is a features, major features of instrumentation amplifier. One is high gain accuracy, high CMRR. High gain stability with the low temperature coefficient, low DC offset, low output impedance. Okay, so here by using this instrumentation amplifier using transducer bridge, so easily can justify that one. Using this the resistive transducer whose resistance changes as a function of some physical energy is one arm of the bridge with a small circle around it, and it is denoted by where RT is the resistance of the transducer, and the change in resistance RT, as per this previous diagram, DC excited but could be AC excited as well for the balanced bridge has some reference conditions where VB is equal to and VOR and RB, where here it is RB of VDC, RB of RC. It is also equal to RA of VDC by RA plus RT. Okay, so major applications are involved using this bridge is balanced initially at a desired reference condition. However, as the physical quantity to be measured changes, the resistance of the transducer also changes. Yeah, here which causes the bridges to unbalance with the help of this VA, where VA not equal to VB. Okay, so this output voltage of the bridge can be expressed as a function of the change in the resistance of the transducer, as described as per this notation VB and all. Let change in the resistance of the transducer del R. So in terms of the del R, since RB and RC are fixed resistors, okay, so the voltage VB is constant. Here it is, if it is VB is constant, however voltage VA varies as a function of the change in transducer resistance. Therefore, according to the voltage divider rule, where VA is equal to RA of VDC by RA plus RT plus del R, where VB is equal to, we know that RB of VDC by RB of RB plus RC. So consequently, the voltage VAB across the output terminal of the bridge is VA. That VA is equal to what you call VA minus VB. So here that already we know that all VA value and VA value and VB value. So we have to substitute these all values. Okay, here RA into VDC by RA plus RT plus del R minus RB into VDC by RB plus RC. So however, if RA is equal to RB, RC is equal to RT is equal to R, then VAB is ready to calculate. Okay, so applications of this operational amplifier, we see due to this all operational amplifier, somewhat it is merit and demerits are available. But one more amplifier, operational amplifier applications, like a major one is the AC amplifier. Yeah, here this AC amplifier, an op amp may be contain a number of differential amplifier stages to achieve a very high voltage gain. Okay, this is a high gain differential amplifier using direct coupling between the output and the input. So this is suitable for DC as well as AC operations. Okay, with reference to this intermediate stage. Okay, that means here we require DC as well as AC operations. Okay, that means where output voltage is equal to positive, when here if it is output voltage is positive, so when V1 greater than V2. So if it is, if you want that V output is equal to 0, when V1 is equal to V2. Like this, an op amp maybe contains a number of differential amplifier stages to achieve a very high voltage gain. So for this case, this is the high gain differential amplifier using the direct coupling between the output and the what you call input. Yeah, this is suitable for DC as well as AC operations. For this case, we are V out and V out positive and V out is equal to 0. The purpose of this circuit is to amplify as a small AC input signal. Okay, so such as an audio or radio frequency signals, where within this signal variation, say a small AC voltage is applied to the input through a what you call coupling capacitor. Hence, such a circuit is useful only as an AC amplifier. So, if you want to construct this AC amplifier, so there is a suitability for DC as well as AC operations. We have to use that all output. Output is equal to positive when V1 greater than V2, where V out is equal to 0 when V1 is equal to V2. So a small AC voltage is applied to the input through a coupling capacitor. So when hence the such a circuit is useful only as an AC amplifier. To amplify DC signals, you should use an operational amplifier. So using this operational amplifier circuit, easily can establish, easily can verify this all what you call suitable for the DC as well as AC operations. Okay. Can op amp amplifier AC? Yeah, maybe. So an operational amplifier is a very high gain voltage amplifier. So if we are using this operational amplifier, you know that all ideal characteristics as well as practical characteristics based on the input impedance, output impedance, what you call voltage gain, CMRR, SVRR and other parameters. So it is used to amplify the signals by increasing its magnitude. So operational amplifier can amplify both DC and AC signals. So within this level, what you call AC amplifier can amplify the what you call AC. So AC amplifier, op amp can be respond to both AC and DC signal. Okay, some applications we need to avoid DC signal and amplify AC signal. So due to this all, based on this, we have two types. First one is inverting AC amplifier circuit. Yeah, this circuit is followed by, here it is inverting terminal. So here that inverting terminal is connected with this what you call resistor I1, so capacitor with Vn. So within this that Vn, so input is Vn, it is connected that what you call capacitor. After that it is charging and discharging, the time the right to verify that current I1, how it is flowing the I1, it is given to the resistor. So we know the importance of this all resistor, it opposes the flow of current. So now it is fed to that, where here inverting near that inverting terminal, where I is equal to 0. Okay, we have inverting AC amplifier circuit where output voltage is equal to minus I1 into R1, that feedback resistor, it is also equal to minus VI into VI, what you call VI by R1 plus 1 by SE. Okay, that RF, where closed loop gain, closed loop gain output voltage by input voltage, it is also equal to minus feedback resistor by R1 S by 1 plus 1 by R1 C1. Okay, so non-inverting AC amplifier, here it is inverting, that inverting terminal is connected with this R1. Okay, non-inverting terminal is connected to the capacitor with the Vn, so input supply with the R2. Okay, R1 is connected to the inverting terminal. So non-inverting AC amplifier with high input impedance. So here it is, what do you call, in terms of that where R1 and R2, here they're adding that one more what do you call inverting terminal, they're connecting what you call capacitor. Okay, so now coming to this voltage follower can be defined as when the output of the operational amplifier circuit follows the input of the op amps directly. So both the input and output voltages are the same. If you are using that voltage follower, is it going to define? So when the output of the operational amplifier circuit follows the input of the operational amplifier directly. So both the input and output voltages are the same. Yeah, this circuit does not supply any amplification. So as a result, voltage gain is equal to 1. Yeah, voltage follower, also known as buffer amplifier, you know that one? Here, unity gain amplifier or what you call isolation amplifier is an op amp circuit. So whose output voltage is equal to the input voltage. So it follows the input voltage, hence voltage follower op amp does not amplify the input signal, but and it has the voltage gain of 1. What is voltage follower? A voltage follower, also known as buffer amplifier, that means unity gain amplifier, or we can consider that what you call isolation amplifier, is an op amp circuit. So whose output voltage is equal to the input voltage, it follows the what you call input voltage. So hence the voltage follower op amps does not amplify the input signal and it has voltage gain of 1. The voltage follower provides no attenuation or amplification. Only it is concerned only what you call buffering. So a voltage follower circuit has a very high input impedance. Because of they are using that op amp. So based on this all connections, inverting and non-inverting terminal. Okay. So within this inverting and non-inverting terminal, where you know that ideal characteristics and the practical characteristics, with reference to this ideal and practical characteristics, voltage follower circuit, it is by using this op amp as a very high input impedance. So these characteristics make it is popular choice in many like different types of circuits that require as isolation between the input and the output. Okay, so the circuit of the voltage follower is like this. Yeah, this is the circuit of voltage follower shown below. Here it is, input is Vin, is that is input, it is approximately 10 volts or what you call that signal, same sort of signal. So it is given to that it is connected with the non-inverting terminal. That inverting terminal is connected to the output. So the output we will expect the same 10 volts output. Okay. So how it is following the voltage follower? So input is, it is also following with the output. So an important law that is underpins a voltage follower is Ohm's. So yeah, the circuit voltage follower is as per this, which is states that circuit's current is equal to its voltage divided by the by its resistance. A mentioned voltage follower have very high input impedance and hence high resistance. That means where current is equal to so voltage by resistance. But before we discuss circuit with the high impedance, it will helpful to first understand that goes on in this circuit with a low impedance. Okay, so a low input impedance and hence resistance in this case, so what you call will result in the R. Okay, so in the formula for Ohm's law being what you call the small. Okay, which fixed voltage, if it is a fixed voltage is available here. Okay, so this will mean that a large amount of current will be drawn by a low impedance load, or load what you call low impedance load, or we can consider that a resistance. Okay, so AC voltage amplifier using the simple circuit diagram, that inverting terminal is connected with the, what you call, the output. That output is connected with the capacitor C2 with the non-inverting terminal. The non-inverting terminal is connected to the C1. The C1 is connected with the supply Vin. Okay, with this, what you call, operation amplifier symbol, we know that one, VCC and VE. With reference to this, the voltage follower, so where VE is the AV volt, what you call, using this all circuits easily can follow. If the design needs an AC response characteristics of the op amp, that is low and high frequency limits, or we can consider that if a DC component must be removed from a signal, then it is necessary to use an AC amplifier. Yes, we know that importance of the AC amplifier. So, for example, in an audio receiver system that consists of number of stages, like because of the thermal drift, component tolerance and variations, the DC level is produced. If you want to consider the block diagram of audio receiver, audio receiver system, so it is in terms of that different stages are available, but in terms of our, while you are using AC amplifier or using the operational amplifier, the component tolerance and the resist, what you call, variations, the DC level is produced. To prevent this amplification of the such a DC levels, coupling capacitor must be used in between stages. So that is the importance of the coupling capacitor. So in the following the block diagram, yeah, it is indicated the capacitor where C1 is represents. That C1 represents the coupling capacitor, which not only blocks the DC, what you call, voltage. So, but also set the low frequency cutoff limits, which is what you call, given by, so where AC amplifier, that FL is equal to 1 by 2 pi CI of RI, RIF plus R0. So, where what you call FL, what you call, low cutoff frequency. So, C is the coupling capacitor or blocking capacitor. Okay, where RIF is the AC input resistance of the second stage. Okay, it is involving that all, each and every parameter, where output resistance, AC output resistance to the first stage, where, or we can consider source resistance or input resistance. Yeah, this is the applications operational amplifier. If they are in the IC versions, like they are using the 741 operational amplifier or 351 operational, what you call, the IC number. AC inverting, 741 and so on, AC non-inverting amplifier, voltage to current converter. So if you want to voltage to converter, so voltage, it's around in and around, we are having that voltage 230 volts. It's to current. How we convert that voltage into current? Say for example, voltage is where V is equal to 230 volts, the 230 volts. How we are converting this voltage into current? The current may be approximately it equal to 2 milliampere or 10 microampere and so on. So that time, so how they are converting this voltage to current converter. So as per this previous diagram shows that the voltage to current converter in which load resistor R is floating, not connected to the ground. The input voltage is applied to the non-inverting terminal because of that circuit is available. Inverting and non-inverting terminal. So here it is, inverting and non-inverting terminal. So based on this inverting and non-inverting terminal, right, to verify that output voltage. Okay, where the voltage across R drives the inverting input terminal. So this circuit is also called as current series negative feedback. So amplifier, because the feedback voltage across R depends on the output current IL and is in series with input difference voltage VED. So writing the voltage equation for the input loop. So this means that in the circuit, an input voltage Vin is converted into an output current of Vin by R. Yeah, the value of the load resistance does not appear in this equation. Therefore, the output current is independent of the value of the load resistance. that is the input voltage is converted into current. Okay, how like this they are converting the voltage is converted to the current. That means now by using this all conversation, by using this all concept, directly you are right to convert this what you call so voltage to current. Like this they are right to convert this one. Thus the input voltage is converted into what you call current. The source must be capable of the supplying this load current. Okay, so using this simple circuit diagram, yeah, this figure shows a voltage to current converter in which load resistor, that load resistor RL, okay, it is mentioned that a load resistor where RL, okay, the input to a voltage is applied to the non-inverting terminal, okay, that is Vin, okay, and the feedback voltage across R drives the inverting input terminal. Check it that diagram. So this circuit is also called as current series negative feedback. So why do the current series negative feedback? The input voltage applied to the non-inverting terminal, and the feedback voltage across the R drives the inverting input terminal. Okay, so the amplifier, because the feedback voltage across the R depends on the output current IL, and is in series with the input difference voltage VD, isn't it? IL and is in the series with the input difference voltage VD. So writing the voltage equation for this input loop. Okay, so using this, where Vin is equal to VF, where Vin is equal to, okay, all right, zero, where I zero is equal to Vin by R. So, but Vd approximately equal to zero, since A is very large. So, therefore, Vin is equal to Vd into Vd plus Vf. Okay, that means where Vin is reflected here. Using this all Vn, where Vn is equal to Vd, that what you call Vd plus Vf. But here it is. So this means that is the circuit an input voltage Vin is converted into an output current of Vin by R. So the value of the load resistance does not appear this equation mathematically. So therefore the output current, yeah, if it is that output current, okay, that output current, there is a deciding factor here. The output current is independent of the value of the load resistor, that is independent of load resistor. So thus the input voltage is converted into current. The source must be capable of supplying this load current. Okay, so grounded load, so voltage to current converter. The load has to be grounded. Okay, as per check it as a previous diagram. Yeah, if the load has to be grounded, so then the G in the above circuit cannot be used. We can modify this circuit. So in terms of this, by using that vertical, so we require that current to voltage converter. So here voltage converter circuit diagram. This is a circuit diagram of current to voltage converter. Due to this virtual ground, the current through R is zero and the input current flows through the feedback resistor. So that feedback resistor is connected to the output. So inverting terminal is connected to the resistor. The resistor also connected with the Vin. Okay, here it is, what you call that current. The current is flowing. So due to this virtual ground, the current through R is zero and the input current flows through the RF. Therefore, output voltage V out is equal to feedback resistor into input current. So the lower limit on this current measures with this circuit is set by the bias current of the inverting input. So next one is a sample and hold circuit is required for implementing its all applications. So the sample and hold circuit, as its name implies, samples as input signal and holds on to it the last sampled value until the input is sampled again. Okay, for this case, so by using the circuit diagram, okay, so it shows that the sample and hold circuit using the operational amplifier with the E-MOSFET. In this circuit, E-MOSFET works as a switch that is controlled by the sample and hold, sample and control voltage Vs, and the capacitor C series as the storage element. Like this, you have to observe the circuit. Here N channel E-MOS, E-MOSFET. So Vin input voltage, where it is sample and hold control voltage. The Vc is available after that, where what you call R is 10 kilo ohm. It is given to that non-inverting terminal. Non-inverting terminal, inverting terminal is connected with the feedback, what you call that output. So here also it is connected to the load resistor. Okay. So with this, is you can observe that all voltage to current, current and voltage. Next, extension of this all application operational amplifier. Here it is the diode D is, what you call D is clamping diode connected across C. The diode clamps the capacitor voltage 0.07, here it is. Okay. So when the output is at plus Vsat, a narrow negative triggering pulse Vt is applied to the non-inverting terminal through a diode D2 to understand the operation of the circuit. Let us assume that the output voltage is at plus Vsat, that is its stable state. The diode D1 conducts and the voltage across the capacitor C, that is Vc, gets clamped to 0.7 volt. So the voltage at the non-inverting input terminal is controlled by the potentium, what you call potentiometric divider of R1 and R2 to beta into V0, that is what you call plus beta into Vsat in the stable state. Okay, so now an inverting comparator. So already we have seen that inverting comparator with a negative feedback. Okay, this circuit converts an what you call irregular shaped wave form to a square wave form or pulse. The circuit is known as Kermit trigger or what you call a squaring circuit. Already we have seen the input voltage is being triggered, the output voltage V naught, every time it is exceeds certain voltage levels called upper threshold VUT and lower threshold voltage VLT. So yeah, these threshold voltages are obtained by the using the voltage divider R1 and R2, where the voltage across R1 is feedback to the negative positive input, the voltage across R1 is variable resistance. Yeah, using this upper threshold VT and lower threshold voltage, where it is all or depends on the value and the polarity of the output voltage V0. When V0 is equal to plus Vsat, the voltage across R1 is called the upper threshold voltage Vout. Like this, using this simple circuit diagram, they are given that input, we will expect that all output response. But here, it is the hysteresis loss, some hysteresis voltage is ready to observe here, that upper threshold voltage minus lower threshold voltage. Okay, an operational amplifier, what you call, can be configured function of the logarithmic amplifier or maybe simple log amplifier. A log amplifier is non-linear, and where linear circuit configuration or using that output is ready to observe that k times to the logarithmic value of the input input voltage is applied. So log amplifiers find the application in computations such as multiplications and division of the signals, computation of the powers and the roads, signal compression and decompression. Because of their right to transmit the signal, there is a reflection with the Vin and R1. So now it is flowing from this E0 and if they are in this transistor. as well as in the process control industrial application, a log amplifier can be constructed using the bipolar junction. That's why it is mentioned that the bipolar junction, that inverting terminal is connected with the that bipolar junction, that the collector is connected to this output voltage. So the transistor is feedback to the op amp, since the collector current of the BJT is logarithmically related to its base emitter voltage. So the necessary condition of the log amplifier to work is that the input voltage always must be positive. It can be seen that V out output voltage is equal to minus VBE. So why it is here minus VBE? Because of that inverting terminal is connected to that BJT. Okay, since the collector terminal of the transistor is held at a virtual ground, and the base terminal is also grounded, the voltage current relationship becomes that of the diode and is given by where I is equal to IS into e power q of VBE by KT minus 1. Where here it is, the IS is, we know that the saturation current, where K also we know that Boltzmann constant, T is the absolutely temperature in Kelvin. Okay. So like this, since where already we know that emitter current is equal to current for the grounded base transistor, due to that it is specified that IC, collector current, is equal to IS into e power q of VBE by KT minus 1, where IC by IS is equal to e power q of VBE of by KT minus 1. Here the easy can finalize that one, simplify this equation where IC by IS plus 1 is equal to e power q of VBE by KT, where IC plus IS by IS is equal to e power q of VBE by KT, where here it is e power q of VBE by KT is equal to IC by IS, since if it is collector current is much greater than IS. So taking the natural logarithm on the both sides of the above equation, so we get VB is equal to KT by Q into ln IC by IS. So the collector current IC is equal to V in input voltage by R1, and output voltage is equal to minus VBE. Therefore, output voltage is like this. Okay. Next one is anti-algorithmic, or we can consider that exponential amplifier, or simply anti-amplifier, anti-log amplifier. Where anti-log amplifier is an op-amp circuit configuration whose output is proportional to the exponential value or anti-log value of the input. Anti-log amplifier does the exact opposite of log amplifier, because of anti-log algorithm or exponential amplifier, or simply anti-log amplifier is by using this operational amplifier circuit configuration. Anti-log amplifier along with the log amplifiers are used to perform analog computations on the input signal. By varying that all due to that signal, these can perform the analog computations on the input signal. The circuit of the anti-log amplifier using the operational amplifier, so it will appear like this. So inverting terminal is connected that BJT. Okay, so that base is connected to the ground. Okay, that emitter is connected to the VIN. Collector is connected to the inverting terminal, that inverting terminal is connected to the vertical R1, the feedback resistor. Okay, now it is, the circuit is followed by anti-logarithmic amplifier. So it is noted that by exchanging the positions of the transistor and the resistor, the log amplifier can be made to work as an anti-log amplifier. The base collector voltage of the transistor is maintained at the ground. If you not maintain that ground, what happens? So we are unable to justify that what you call the exchange, the position of the transistor and the resistor. The what you call amplifier can be made to work as the anti what you call log amplifier. So the base collector voltage of the transistor is maintained at ground potential from the virtual ground concept. The current IE, emitter current for the transistor is given by, so where is that emitter current, consider that as a previous circuit diagram, okay. So where emitter current is equal to IS and e power q of VBE by KT minus 1. So for the grounded base transistor, IE is equal to IC, therefore where collector current is equal to IS and e power q of VBE by KT minus 1, where IS is saturation current of the transistor, where output voltage is equal to IC into R1, where output voltage is measured, where output voltage is equal to what you call IS into e power q of VBE, q of, so e power q of VBE by KT minus 1 into R1, it is specified. So also for the above circuit where Vin is equal to minus VBE, so therefore, so the output voltage will be changed, or that output voltage is equal to R1 into IS into e power q of minus V in and K by KT by minus 1. Okay, op amps multivibrator, already we have verified the solar, op amp is the multivibrator. So due to the solar, we have to consider what you call, okay, next. We have to consider the next non-linear applications of operational amplifier. One is, okay, so previous one is linear applications of operational amplifier. We have verified that one, linear and non-linear applications of operational amplifier one. Second level is what you call the triangular, sawtooth and a square wave generator. Triangular, sawtooth, square wave generator and log and anti-log amplifier. Here it is, already we know that the sinusoidal is, so like this we are right to drawing that a sinusoidal waveform, sinusoidal signal, positive of going, negative of cycle and positive of cycle and so on. But if it, here it is non, triangular, sawtooth and square wave, these are the non-sinusoidal waveform. Here it is, if it is a square wave, this also non-sinusoidal. These are all sinusoidal. This are non-sinusoidal waveform. Or sawtooth, okay, like this, okay, and a square wave generator and so on. So waveform generator. A waveform generator is an electronic circuit which generates the standard wave. So there are two types of operational amplifier based waveform generator. One is the square wave generator. Next one is triangular wave generator. Yeah, this module discuss each of this operational amplifier based waveform generator is detailed. Maybe you have to consider the square wave generator, after that triangular wave generator. Yeah, in square wave generator, the square wave generator is an electronic circuit which generates square wave by using operational amplifier, or if it is op amp based square wave generator. Why is the op amp based square wave generator? Because of you are using this operational amplifier. Okay, you are using this operational amplifier, you have to consider the square wave generator. So the circuit diagram of op amp based square wave generator is shown in figure. You can observe this one here. That inverting terminal is connected to the Vin, what you call connected with the capacitor with ground. So non-inverting terminal is this with this VP. With the R3 and R2 is connected to the output. So where R1 is also connected, this is the feedback resistor R1. Okay, so observe this. This is the circuit diagram shown this. The resistor R1, where is that resistor? That may be in terms of the feedback R1. R1 is connected between the inverting terminal, isn't it? So inverting terminal input inverting input terminal of the operational amplifier and its output of operational amplifier. So the resistor R1 is used in the negative feedback, isn't it? Either positive feedback or negative feedback. Why it is the inverting terminal is connected to the R1? So similarly, the resistor R2, here it is, the resistor R1 and R2, where a resistor R2 is connected between the non-inverting input terminal of the op amp and its output. So the resistor R2 is used in the positive feedback. Here it is, this is the positive feedback, here it is negative feedback. Okay. So a capacitor is connected between the inverting input terminal of the operational amplifier and the ground. So the voltage across the capacitor will be in the input voltage at this inverting, that inverting terminal of op amp. So similarly, the resistor R3 is connected between the non-inverting input terminal of the operational amplifier and ground. So the voltage across resistor R3 will be in the input voltage at this non-inverting terminal of the op amp. So the operation of the square wave generator, assume there is no charge storage in the capacitor initially, then the voltage present at the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier is 0 volts. So with this, there is no some offset voltage at a non-inverting terminal of op amp. Due to this, the value present at the output of above circuit will be positive plus Vsat. Now the capacitor starts the charging through the resistor R1. That is, R1 is a negative feedback. The value present at the output of the above circuit will change to what you call minus Vsat. When the voltage across the capacitor reaches just greater than the voltage positive value across the resistor R3, the capacitor C starts the charging through a resistor R1 when the output of the above circuit is minus Vsat. So, like this, the value present at the output of above circuit will change to plus Vsat when the voltage across the capacitor reaches just less than the more maybe negative, the voltage negative value across resistor R3. Thus, the circuit shown this above figure will produce the square wave at the output as shown in figure. Like this. Yeah, using this all operation, you easily can verify that all plus Vsat or minus Vsat. Here is the positive going transitions to negative going transition and positive going transition to negative going transition. That means it is nothing but output voltage in terms of this. This is the square wave. So from the figure, we can observe that from this previous figure, due to that figure only, we will expect that output response. We can observe that the output of the square wave generator will have one of the two values, like one is plus Vsat and minus Vsat. Here it is variable plus Vsat and minus Vsat. So the output remains at one value for the some duration, and then transition the transistor to another value, okay, remain there for some duration. In this way, what do you call, it contains, okay, it contains all values. Now coming to the triangular waves, triangular wave generator. A triangular wave generator is an electronic circuit which generates a triangular wave because of your even the electronic component. So the block diagram of a triangular wave generator, so it is by using the operational amplifier op amp. Okay, here it is square wave generator where it is given to that integrator. We will expect that a triangular wave. Okay, so using this one, but the triangular generator using the operational amplifier only. So here it is mentioned that our inverting terminal, that inverting terminal is given to that capacitor, capacitor is grounded. What are the non-inverting terminal? Vp and R3. So where here negative feedback is this R1 is connected here and R2, okay, and output voltage, it is given to that what you call R1, R2 or R3. So inverting terminal, that inverting terminal is connected to the C1. Here it is, because of why it is C1 and this left side circuit is followed by what you call square wave generator. So next this click on this square wave generator, okay, and click on this integrator. It is available by using operational amplifier. Now here it is, what do you call, this is your okay integrator and square wave generator. You combine this one, square wave generator, output is given to this integrator. So you will export the output voltage. That means the block diagram of the triangular wave generator contains mainly two blocks, a square wave generator and an integrator. So these two blocks are cascaded, check it as per this diagram. That means the output of the square wave generator is applied as an input of integrator here, isn't it? So note that the integration of the square wave is nothing but a triangular wave. Yeah, the circuit diagram of an op amp based triangular wave generator is shown in figure. So here, so we have already seen that circuit diagram of the square wave generator and an integrator. Observe that we got the above circuit diagram of an operational amplifier based triangular wave generator by replacing the blocks with the, what you call, respective above circuit diagram in the block diagram of what you call triangular wave generator. So an inverting comparator with positive feedback, the circuit converts an irregular shape waveform of the square waveform or pulse. The circuit is known as symmetric gap or square, what you call squaring circuit. Okay, this also somewhat we require this input voltage being triggered. The output voltage, every time it is exceeds certain voltage levels, it's called upper and lower threshold. Okay, this all are verified. Okay, so an operational amplifier can be configured in terms of this log amplifier. Here it is assigned that, okay, yeah. So the circuit known as the symmetric or square circuit, the input voltage is being triggered. The output voltage, every time it is exceeds certain voltage levels, it is called upper threshold and the lower threshold voltage. These threshold voltages are obtained by using voltage divider R1, R2, where the voltage across R1 is feedback to the positive input. The voltage across R1 is variable reference. Threshold voltage that depends on the value and polarity of the output voltage V0. When V0 is equal to plus, we said the voltage across R1 is called the particular upper threshold voltage and so on. Already we know that. Like this, it's also verified. So now it is now coming to this log amplifier. Log amplifier, or we can consider that what you call operational amplifier, logarithmic amplifier, because of you are using the op amp. So an operational amplifier can be configured to function as a logarithmic amplifier or simply so log amplifier. A log amplifier is a nonlinear circuit configuration where the output is k times the logarithmic value of the input voltage applied. Okay, so that means log amplifier find the applications in computation such as the multiplication, okay, division of the signals, computation of the power and roots, signal compression and decompression as well as process. Already we have seen that, but here it is in terms of logarithmic amplifier using that operational amplifier. Okay, so log amplifier can be constructed using the bipolar junction. Okay, transistor feedback, this also we have verified. It can be seen that output voltage is equal to minus VBE and the terminal is grounded based on the circuit diagram, or it is calculated this all parameter. Okay, the parameters, so VBE is also like this, the output voltage. Okay, since we are emitter current is equal to collector current for the grounded base transistor. Okay, so next one is anti-log amplifier. Anti-logarithmic, or we can consider the exponential amplifier, or simply anti-log amplifier, is an operational amplifier circuit configuration. How it is configured? Using that, by using the operational amplifier only, there is a possibility whose output is proportional to the exponential value or anti-log value of the input. Anti-log amplifier does not exert opposite of a log amplifier. Yeah, so sometimes they are using the exact opposite, but it is not exact opposite of log amplifier. Anti-log amplifiers along with the log amplifiers are used to perform analog computations on the input signal. So the circuit of an anti-log amplifier using operational amplifier is shown in this figure. Here it is, inverting terminal is connected to this one, non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground, where R1, this output voltage is ready to measure. So like this, it is noted that by exchanging the positions of the transistor and the resistor, okay, so the log amplifier can be made to work as the anti-log amplifier. The base collector voltage of the transistor is maintained at ground potential from the virtual ground concept. The current IE for the transistor is given by, so what do you call that, where emitter current is equal to IS into e power q of VBE by KT minus 1. For a grounded base transistor, IE is equal to IC, therefore, so IC is equal to IS into e power q of VBE by KT minus 1, where IS is saturation current of the transistor. Output voltage is equal to collector current into R1. So, where output voltage is measured, where IS into e power, because of, you know that IS, what you call that collector current, we know that IC value is right to substitute here. Okay, where IS into e power q of VBE by KT minus 1 into R1. So, also for the above circuit, input voltage is equal to minus VBE. Therefore, output voltage is, now it is changed, that means right to calculate the updated output voltage, R1 into IS into what you call e power q minus V in by KT minus 1. Okay, nonlinear application of the operational amplifier as voltage regulator. Okay, so here, so we will see that, yeah, next class we will see this nonlinear application.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.